Manu Bhai Shah Memorial Award in Research and Excellence in the Area of Commerce and Management. And it involves cash prize of 2 lakh as well. And in addition to this, I have also been, you know, conferred British Academic Award. This is the award which is given by British Academy, Commonwealth, in the year 2005. And at that time, I was working on the project market orientation. What is the quality of market orientation in the banks? In addition to that, I have also had the exposure to join Gandhi Institute of Business Technology in Jakarta as a visiting fellow. I had been there for 2 years. And along with that, you know, as far as my research criteria is concerned, I have been awarded a Senior Award by one of the international journals published by Emerald. And the title of the journal, it is the International Journal of Healthcare Quality Assurance. In addition to that, there are a number of publications on my side. I have 100 plus publications, including publications which are featured in listed Scopus, index journals, along with ABDC. And this, I have also, you know, supervised 20 plus PhD scholars in different marketing areas, including some of the, you know, finance topics. And I have guided about 30 plus MPhil students also in different areas. Regarding the selection of AMU, being HOD of the department, being looking after the, you know, Udhampur campus, I was very perplexed because, you know, December beginning, being the, you know, peak season in the teaching. It was so difficult for me to take leave at that particular period of time. So I was considering myself very lucky that, you know, AMU has organized training program at the, you know, end of this December where I could, you know, make myself free and attend this particular program. As far as the other two institutions they were concerned, their times they were clashing with my teaching period, teaching time. So I could not take off at that particular period of time. That is why, you know, I have the pleasure to join you all in this training program at AMU. Now, concerning about my experience at AMU, now basically the training program has given me various, you know, learning aspects relating to, you know, university-society relationship, how to rank our institution in terms of NAF rating and in terms of, you know, NIRF. What are the parameters which we have to look into in order to enhance the ranking of the institutions? What is the importance of conducting, you know, research based upon the, you know, industrial problems? And what is the significance of alumni association, which we are, our association in University of Jammu is not so effective. So that is why I was very much, you know, curious to understand what are the important parameters to make the alumni very effective. What is the role of SAM, Moodle and MOOC in delivering technology-based, you know, education, content, etc. The key takeaways are in three. First one, how we can use Moodle in teaching pedagogy, how to make alumni association effective, and secondly, how to, you know, record video lectures and we can, you know, upload that in the, you know, Moodle software or YouTube. My future plan is that I need to, you know, enhance the knowledge structure of my university in terms of technology when we are talking about the delivery of the classes. So I'll try to, you know, implement Moodle at the departmental level first, and after that I'll take it across different departments so that everybody can take the benefit of this Moodle pedagogy. And in addition to that, again, my focus will be how I can make my, you know, alumni of University of Jammu in and particular Department of Commerce in particular very effective in different areas. And lastly, I would like to thank, you know, MHRD for selecting me, and I am also very you know, thankful to the, you know, center and especially Professor Kidwai, Dr. Faiza for giving us very warm, you know, hospitality over here. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Professor Parvaiz. Good morning, my colleagues. I'm Dr. Lakshman from VIT University, Vellore. So I did my PhD in IIT Madras in the year 2004 in the field of computer science, and followed by I did my postdoc in CWI Amsterdam and also in India, Rocco, France. And then I have about 50 plus publications, some 30 plus international journal publications, and about 23 conference international conference proceedings. So, I'm actually heading my department of analytics, where I manage about 23 faculties and about 5 supporting staffs. And I also manage 2 programs. One is BTEC CSE with specialization in bioinformatics, and the other one is BTEC CSE with specialization in IoT. So my interest to attend this leave, first of all, actually I want to elevate myself for a better higher administrative position. So then I saw this leave notice and I was very much impressed, and the themes are, you know, very much motivating me to apply for that. And my choice for AMU is, I didn't have a better choice because last month I had a plan to go to Czech, and so I couldn't choose IIT Kharagpur. And similarly, the next one I had teaching, my assignment is there, so I couldn't cut it much. So these dates are very convenient to me. And of course, I know AMU even from at least my bachelor's days. In fact, when I wanted to do my master's, I wanted to apply here. Those days, I saw this master's program in that employment news notice. So I remember that I have seen this AMU call for notification. I wanted to apply and all. So I know this for a long time, and I'm happy to be here. So what I learned is over these days is actually there are a lot of, you know, very interesting talks, lectures were given by the experts. So some things that I learned is accreditation, the need for accreditation, what are the funding, research funding opportunities available at national and international level, and need for quality research, need for accreditation. And also the role play actually exposed me to different types of the problems that the administrators they face in their day-to-day life, and the flipped classroom, blended classroom, MOOC, and also the Moodle, the online classrooms, all this I came to know. Also the what is VUCA situation, what is gamification, and the educational policies, all this I have come to know. Well, that's very interesting, and some of them I have equipped days to say how to make online videos, or how you can, decision making is one of the things that I also like it. I know the role plays help us to take a decision, so that helps me in the decision planning. And how to counseling, that was also interesting. We have to give counseling to the students, and how to prepare visionary statement. So they are very useful to me. Of course, I wish the program could have been a little more interesting. So just maybe mention a few points. Of course, we know that, you know, the, when the program was started in the first week, a lot of disturbance was there. But the second week, compared to the first week, the second week was very good. So when some people talk, the research person talks about accreditation, he was just restricting to NAC accreditation. And there are a lot of other accreditation. NARF is another important one, QS, Times Higher. So he has to make an overall comparison, what are the criteria for this, like that, then it will be interesting. And also like, in fact, when today morning Professor Parvaiz talked about that register, you know, like when it comes some issues to his table, he explained that in one paragraph and the VC knows what are the choices. So in fact, we would have been happier to see such cases, you know, that will help us for our decision making. So kindly include those things maybe in our next LEAP program. And we need to also have more group activity, because group activity help us to learn others better, where we can interact others. So we want to have, and the visits are scheduled also as part of the program. It's better they are scheduled after 4:30. So these are my observations, and thank you very much.
Approaches toward real-life administrative challenges. as we grow old, our role and nature of responsibilities changes. With the synergy, various administrative responsibilities are bestowed on us, which demands a completely different skill set. So we have learned a different set of. Sometimes, due to lack of such administrative training and exposure, many successful acquisitions fail to deliver. Hence, such programs form the basis for preparing oneself for challenging administrative job. So it is boost to make a challenge. We have accepted a challenging job. It is obvious from global learning scenario that traditional learning is supplemented by long life learning. So for long life learning, we have to modern teaching and learning aids have become a necessity. So we have to learn modern learning aids and modern teaching. So it will help for long life learning. The widespread availability of internet and ICT enabled educational technology had made it possible to reach at the doorstep of the learners. Now the future agenda of mine is to translate and transfer my subject knowledge and experiences by ICT enabled educational technology to digital knowledge base, which can further be utilized by the future generation learner by using upcoming AI technology, because AI technology are very, very important in play a vital role in every sphere of life. So as administrator, my focus would be to design and implement AI artificial enabled e-governance system for the betterment of the society in large. So this is the future plan for that. Thank you very much.
Okay, so I think I have got sufficient inputs for this round also. So the first thing which I wish to comment on, we have been talking about effective C's of presentation. I would add one more dimension to it, ineffective C's of presentation. So that also may be focused on. So here you have effective one. What is a cliché? Cliché is something which we call pet phrases. इसका कोई बहुत मतलब नहीं होता, but we end up using it. For example, in case of one of our colleague, the cliché was you know. In other case, the cliché was like. And I think both these speakers, I was trying to count, they must have used it at least 10 times in their presentation. Like. Likewise, we all develop our own cliché. And this unnecessarily wastes our communication time. And incidentally, both of them overshot by 30 seconds or so. If they would have just done away with that part, they would have finished it. So, अच्छा फिर इसमें एक खतरा भी होता है टीचर को कि वो यू नो से आ गए तो अक्सर जो है जो नाम पढ़ता है वो इसी पढ़ता है. So I think just become more conscious of it. I'm not saying become too conscious of it, but are there some pet phrases which we have been using unnecessarily? which we can avoid. Then one thing which I noted in this round, especially those of you who overshot the time, actually there were four parts. Making this judgment, how much I am going to share, is extremely important. We call it actually mon plan. Mon plan means what I must say, what I ought to say, and what I may say.
Must,
ought, and may. So I was reading this on effective presentations. There was a book. In fact, it suggested that we need to have three versions of our presentation. One, the standard version, then an abridged version, and also an expanded version. आप लोगों ने अक्सर महसूस किया होगा कॉन्फ्रेंसेज में ये सिचुएशन बहुत आ जाती है कि आपको इनिशियली यू आर टोल्ड दैट यू हैव 7 मिनट्स और 8 मिनट्स और पता चला समबडी ओवरशॉट द टाइम लास्ट द चेयर इज रिक्वेस्टिंग इज आप प्लीज फिनिश इन 4 मिनट्स सो वी शुड नॉट बी कॉट ऑफ गार्ड एंड वी शुड बी रेडी विद 3 वर्जन सो दैट वी आर वेरी क्लियर दैट दिस इज द कोर थिंग व्हिच आई एम गोइंग टू से इफ टाइम परमिट्स आई मे ऐड दिस पॉइंट्स इफ देन अक्सर ऐसा हुआ देखिए जो लोग जैसे आप बुखारी भाई आपके साथ भी हुआ हो लास्ट पार्ट में वी हैड टू रश तो ऐसा ना हो कि कहीं गुड बिकम्स द एनिमी ऑफ द बेस्ट जो आप कोर बात कहना चाह रहे हैं उसकी कॉस्ट पे आप कुछ ऐसी डिटेल्स शेयर कर रहे हैं इनिशियली जैसे मुझे दोनों के केसेस में लगा प्रोफेसर चंद्रशेखर के केस में भी लगा एंड ऑल्सो इन केस ऑफ मैडम हरदीप That perhaps background was elaborated too much. We could have, you know, curtailed that part, and then you would have had more time on the learnings that you have had from this book. And then, so
the photographer is here, so this is the last chance for those who were not there in the photograph yesterday. Dono,
please.
I think that was a rather. How about those
They will be photoshopped into the group.
Yes.
At which position?
Last they will add it. Last both of us. Both of us.
Very much, Mahari. Thank you so much for your worry and anxiety. You must not suffer from anxiety, but that will be very harmful for you.
Very nicely.
I was talking about this point that try to make sure that the core points do not suffer at the cost of not so important points. I would not say they were not important, but it was something better that we shared. Then Dr. Chandrasekhar, I am very happy that you made this choice. Come to a central university, and you elaborated it very well. I was talking about this point of correct. For example, just one reflection. You said your experience here has been very good. Now, if I were to say reword it, and if I say my experience here has been very different. Same thing but conveying a very different actually what you had in mind because coming from a NIT kind of setup then this and primarily exposed to technical universities up till now and now getting exposed to a more cosmopolitan university so the experience yes it goodness is one part of it I think the more important part is different So that's a way of growing up, having all such differences, different experiences. Now, in the end, one comment which you made, if you can address your bias, negative, the prejudices that we have, you can be a good leader. This was what our friend said. Just see, if we can personalize it, we can say, if I can address my biases and prejudices that we all have, I can be a good leader. Which one sounds better?
Because it is my presentation, I must. It should not be generic, it should be my I.
Again, if you go back into the deeper part of it, it is part of the same psyche that we develop as a teacher. We tend to generalize.
So this is disadvantages of being a teacher for so many years.
Professional hazard. I would say professional hazard of being a teacher.
That's what I do all the time.
And actually, the toughest thing, Professor Bhai, for a teacher is to listen to others. Because we are always in this mode of speaking. We get paid for speaking. And the toughest training that I have had as a trainer of group discussions is that I have learned to listen.
But I think, I believe in. I am not sure what I told, but what I said was, I believe in
that you can be a.
Yeah.
So, okay. Again, I am not saying, please accept everything that
I say.
In toto.
Yes.
Just reflect on it, please.
Yes.
Because all of, I saw a very beautiful statue in Gandhinagar. We have a friend from Gandhinagar here. I visited that Akshardham temple. And there was a statue over there. This statue was in the form of a half carved stone. And it was like this, that this raw stone was placed over there. Half of the human body had come out of it. Half of it was still inside the stone. And the beautiful part of that statue was that two hands which had come out, the person was shown holding a hammer and a chisel in his hand. And it appeared as if the person is chiseling himself out of that stone. Trust me, nobody can develop anybody. We have to do our own chiseling. Yes, these forums, they provide us an occasion to reflect. So, if I'm suggesting something, just take it as a point of reflection. Reflect on it. If you find that it suits your reality or fits it into your reality, fair enough. Otherwise, the best education is one that we give to ourselves. So, then Hardeep ma'am, देखिए Hardeep ma'am में एक बात आपने नोट की होगी. Most of us were speaking from here. But she preferred this place. And she was basically interacting from it. So the choice also, choice of the place from where we deliver. Like for example, now I have come over here. Does it make a difference?
Yes. Yeah. More environment wise.
So if we are, one part of, you know, effective speaking is making a choice even on that account from where I would interact. And her overall demeanor was that she was very pleasant, very jovial, very into it, into the presentation, and a very, overall she gave an impression that she's a very pleasant company. Now, where we need to, if she may reflect on, I've already told you about that, you know, thing.
Yeah.
Now you know it. And again, coming to that balance part, perhaps why AMU and background part was elaborated a bit more than the part. This could have been part. And then, actually the challenge of communication is, I will use green color. किसी को गागर मिसाले हो
by using proper vocabulary
proper